watching this film, I think Fahad Fazil needs to come down to Mumbai and give acting 101 lessons to a lot of stars in Bollywood. Hi everyone, welcome to I Just React and Review. My name is Ashmita. Hope you all are doing well. And today I come to you with a review of a film that made me a complete fan of Fahad Fazil. The movie I'm talking about is Trance. And well, this was really not a movie for me. This was an experience that I had. Now, before I delve into the various aspects of the film, I just want to put it out as a disclaimer that this film might not be everybody's cup of tea. Like, a lot of people might not be able to digest this kind of a film. But does that mean that you should give this film a miss? Absolutely not. I think as an audience, we also need to be more accepting to different kinds of film. And this is a film we should definitely give a chance as an audience because of its out-of-the-box narration and storyline. The movie charts the journey of the character Viju Prasad from a small-time motivational speaker to this huge pastor, miracle worker who makes people believe that he is the messenger of God and he can actually cure diseases just by the touch of his hands. So Viju gets hired by this huge industrialist Solomon Davis, who trains him to become Pastor Joshua Carton so that he can just rob innocent people of their blind faith and earn money. Now, this particular thing intrigued me a lot about this film because when it comes to religion, we are very sensitive about it, right? Because whenever faith or religion is depicted in movies, we want it to be depicted in the best possible way, right? So when the negative aspects of blind faith was shown in the film, like, you know, how blind faith can be detrimental to people as well, I was appreciative of the director for taking such a bold creative decision. Now, at its heart, it's a psychological thriller which centers around Fahad's character. But there are various other topics that also has been touched upon really well by the director. For example, you know, showing the mental health issues of a person, then addressing the topic of blind faith, showing the fakeness of the world, like how something which is polished and presented nicely, it is fake, but if it is presented nicely, marketed well, people are going to, you know, consider that as truth and just gobble it up. So I think these are the things very nicely and very clearly shown in the film, which I really liked. Now, two brilliant technical aspects of this film is the sound design and the camera work of the film, the cinematography done. The sound design is done by Russell Pukutti, who is, well, a master at what he does. I don't even have to elaborate. He's an Oscar winner, so I don't think I'm even qualified to, you know, talk about him. But there are various places where the sound has been used and engineered so perfectly, specifically in the places where, in the scenes where Fahad is addressing this big mass of people, and there's a lot of energy that has to be brought in that scene. Yes, it has been brought by Fahad's acting also, but I think the addition of those background sounds made it even more better. If I talk about the camera work of the film is shot in various different angles, like especially in the second half where Fahad is addressing like big crowds. But what I loved were the close-up shots of Fahad, where he's contemplating, he's thinking about the past, self-reflecting. Those were the shots that were my favorite because it felt like I was looking into Fahad's soul. I mean, it is backed by his awesome acting, but I think those close-up shots were the highlight for me. The film is directed by Anwar Rashid, and the direction of this film, if I have to put it in one word, I would say unique. And I say this because if you watch the film, you will feel that you are watching two different films. The first half of the film, the direction of the first half of the film is so different from the second half of the film. You will actually feel that these are two separate movies. Now, with that statement, I want to give a disclaimer that it might not be everybody's cup of tea, because, you know, when an audience is invested in certain kind of a narration and suddenly that style of narration changes and the entire look and feel of the film changes, they might not accept it. They might think, no, I like this way of narration. This is not my thing. I'm not liking this. So that was a risk that the director took. For me personally, I liked the shift in narration because there was a shift in the psychological thinking of the main character, and this movie is centered around Fahad's character. So when there was a shift in Fahad's mental state and psyche and the way he was thinking, the entire look and feel and narration of the film changed. And I think that was, for me, that was a very smart decision taken by the director. It might not be for everyone, it worked for me, it might not work for you as an audience. Okay, before I go complete gaga over Fahad's performance, I want to just mention that all the other supporting cast in the film are absolutely top notch. They have given amazing, amazing performances. Each and every supporting cast is so unique and so important to the storyline, and a lot of these supporting cast have their own arc which makes you feel invested in them. For example, Nazriya's character as Esther Lopez, she has her own past, and how she becomes who the person she is now is beautifully shown. In a very short span of time, she comes in the second half, but that mini arc shown of hers is so well done and well integrated in the film. It absolutely makes for a wonderful narration. Subin Shahir as the journalist Matthews has a very brief role, but such an important role and will be so impactful that by the end of it, you will actually feel for this character. Imagine my joy when Srinath popped on screen. I mean, I didn't know he was a part of this film. He plays Fahad's younger brother Kunjan, and what an important character, because his presence in Fahad's life and how Fahad is affected by his younger brother is a very important arc to his story as well. There is one more character, Thomas, played by Vinayakan. Such an important character. It actually shows the reality of people who put all their faith and all their trust blindly into something can be so detrimental to you and your family. Then you have the central negative supporting characters, Gautam Menon as Solomon Davis, Dilish Pothan as Avrachan, and Chamban Vinod as Isaac. All three of them are so good in the film, and all three of them play such pivotal role in shaping up Fahad's character arc completely. That's why I'm saying every supporting cast is just as important as the main cast. I loved Gautam Menon as Solomon Davis. I think his character was written very well, like shrewd, cold, calculative, smart, has a personality, and the way he acted in a very restrained manner, like he didn't shout at the top of his voice that, oh, I'm the bad guy and, you know, I'm the smartest guy on the planet, I'm a big industrialist. I think the restraint in his acting, the way he emoted with his eyes, I think that was one of the key highlights for me in the performances in the film. Ah, now let's talk about Fahad Fasil. I mean, what should I even say? I'm literally like, guys, I'm speechless after watching this performance. You know what? When I was watching his complete character arc, like his shift in his character and the way he was portraying this character, you know what it reminded me of? I'm gonna give a big statement here, huh? It reminded me of Joaquin Phoenix's Joker. Like, he won Oscar for that, right? And that is what I was watching. I was watching an Oscar-winning performance. He is unbelievable. I mean, if I just say he knocked it out of the park, I think that would be the biggest understatement of the century. I think he was, I don't know, he was beyond epic in this movie. Everything about his performance in this film is an 11 on 10. It's not even 10 on 10, it's 11 on 10. Like, I couldn't find even like the smallest of flaws in his acting. It was that perfect. His portrayal as a small-time motivational speaker who's trying to make his ends meet and also support his younger brother, so beautifully shown. It was so realistic that you will feel that your heart is getting ripped apart by looking at him. The portrayal of his character's mental state has been shown so well. Like, in this film, it has been shown so beautifully that a traumatic event that happens in your childhood can affect your entire life. Till the day you die, it can still affect you mentally. And he has shown it literally with his eyes. That's it. How did you even do that, Fahad? Like, I am awestruck. The subtlety of his acting in so many scenes, for example, in one of the scenes where he's standing in front of the mirror and actually trying to, you know, boost his own confidence, like saying, you know, you are a confident person, you can achieve anything in life, you are a positive person. You know, he is self-boosting himself, but the pain in his eyes is so evident. How did you do it, Fahad? I mean, bowing down to you, man. This man's energy is on a different level. Like, there are scenes as Pastor Joshua Carlton where he has to, you know, address this crowd and pump up the crowd, and the energy that he has put into those scenes, like I felt literally he has eaten up the script and you know become this character himself. So good. Bollywood, if you do not utilize this man and actually cast him in a mainstream Bollywood film, it is going to be such a huge loss, not just for the film industry, but for the audiences as well. Well, like it or not, Bollywood has a much bigger reach in terms of, you know, getting the audience's attention. And I absolutely want every freaking Indian to know about this man, because he is a freaking gem of our country. He can give the best of the Bollywood A-listers a run for their money. And I am not joking. This is a big statement that I'm giving right now. So yes, Fahad Fazil is the crown of this film. And I think Fahad Fazil is someone who should be known by each and every Indian, or at least each and every movie lover. This is a very quirky and out of the box film. So maybe a lot of people might not feel invested in the movie. They would feel, no, I am not able to connect with the storyline or the film. But you know what? We also need to grow as an audience. And I would urge everybody who has come across this video and watching this review to please give this film a chance. It is streaming on Amazon Prime. Do watch it. You will be blown away by the performances. And yes, I admit that the direction of the film, the storyline is a little out of the box. It's a little different, but sometimes different is good. So if you have come till the end of the video, thank you so much for watching. This was my analysis and perspective for the film Trance. Please do give it a go. It is streaming on Amazon Prime. And do let me know in your thoughts on the comment section below, what you liked or disliked about this film. Did you connect with the film or did you not connect with the film? And some other perspective that I probably would have missed out in the film, please let me know. I would love to know your thoughts. And do like, share and comment. And please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. I'll see you on my next video, guys. Bye-bye.